Let's consider the pros and cons of the make choice, which means carrying out activities within the company, in turn increasing the company's vertical integration level. A first advantage will be the dropping or disappearing of transaction cost. But what are transaction costs? They are the cost to be borne in order to work with the external market, to carry out a commercial transaction with one or more third-party suppliers. If I can perform an activity within the company, I will not need a supplier, and I will eliminate cost for scouting, evaluation, and selection of suppliers. Let's consider, for example, the vendor rating process, as well as administration and legal cost, like cost to draft the contract, and potential logistic cost. A second advantage, at the same time, is that I will internalize the supplier's margin, as I will have to pay no margin to third parties. The only costs borne in this make option are internal costs for performing and managing activities. Other advantages are the increased control on activities' cost guaranteed by direct execution, together with better control and development of potential core resources and skills linked to the internalized activity itself, like know-how or adopted procedures, which over time will be otherwise acquired and covered only by suppliers. A last advantage of the make option is the elimination of the problem of reliance on the supplier, which often leads to the company losing sight of real cost of the activity and to weakening control of resources that are possibly key for competitive advantage. The make option has nevertheless also a number of disadvantages, which also dually represent the advantages of the buying or outsourcing option. First of all, our company could be less efficient than a given external supplier in carrying out the activity, due to the effect of scale economies and experience economies. Suppliers are likely to carry out the same activity for a number of customers and will therefore have a higher scale and learning speed than the single company can achieve alone. They will have higher production levels, quickly running down the experience curve, with positive effects on average cost per unit. Another obvious disadvantage of the make option is the higher investment in fixed capital, since in order to carry out the activity within the company, the need in capital can be high and expenses include long-term assets representing fixed cost, which are not related to production volumes. Indeed, contrarily to making, the buy-in option is a way to turn fixed cost into variable cost, depending on the actual volumes the company supplies from the external market. The make option also requires cost linked to hierarchic coordination of the activity, which becomes part of the company itself. It is important to underline, though, that even outsourcing partially entails coordination cost, as the company changes its role from executor to coordinator, thus controlling the supplier's work. Another problem linked to the make option is the lack of motivation that could arise in highly integrated companies, as human resources performing non-core activities can feel poorly motivated, or low incentives to efficiency and effectiveness may be present when captive market conditions arise. That is, a company or SBU is forced by corporate rules to acquire as inputs the outputs of another SBU belonging to the same corporate portfolio. The combined assessment of these pros and cons should drive a company's strategic decision favoring vertical integration or outsourcing.